not, Brother Larry. Grab you a Burgundy Hymnal and turn to page 107. You take prayer requests, and this song says, "I must tell Jesus." Any burdens that we have, bring them to Jesus.
Burdens alone.
favorite songs to do, and I know oftentimes it's done as an invitational, so we don't get to sing all those verses most of the time. But I love the story of that, because no matter what's going on, bring it to Jesus. That last verse, oh how the world to evil allures me. We go through these temptations down here on earth. We just bring those to Jesus. He can help us win that victory, as the verse states. So you have, no matter what you got going on in your life, bring it to Jesus. Anybody got a special this evening? All right, Brother Neal, it's all on you then. You can even sing us one if you want to.
We want to have somebody here at the end, so. Yeah, Kathy can sing, but I can't, so. My boys got all of their music ability from their mother and from their granddaddies, but they did not get it from me, so I'm not even allowed to sing in the shower, so that tells you how bad it is. Take your Bible tonight, your copy of God's Word, and open to the book of Colossians chapter 3. The book of Colossians chapter 3. And I want to share with you tonight just simply a message that I have entitled Praise. I think that the time of year that it is, Kathy and I were talking about as we were driving down for church, and I was telling her that it's just absolutely amazing that in the past 2 weeks that the fields along the road have gone from brown to green. And the trees are blooming, and some of the flowers are blooming. And so it is a wonderful time of year to see the newness of life that God is bringing with the spring of the year. I love to see spring come. I don't like winter. I don't like the cold. I don't like it getting dark at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. There's not much about winter other than Christmas that I like. And so I enjoy spring. When the time changes, when everything starts coming to life again, I really enjoy that. And so tonight I want us just to think about the idea of praise, because I think that where we are this time of year, Easter's just a couple of weeks down the road, and so it ought to be a time where that we are praising God, that our life ought to be filled with praise because of what's going on. The word praise, if you look it up in the dictionary, it says to commend the worth of, express approval of, to laud the glory of God, as in song, commendation, or glorification. The Hebrew word for that is translated as praise in the verses that we're going to read has the sense of to acknowledge God's character and works, or man's character. And praise is the recognition of another's character or works. To praise God is to declare who God is, what He does, and praise honors God because of His divine deeds and character, and how that plays out in our lives. So Paul wrote these verses in Colossians chapter 3, and let's look at those. Let's begin at verse 15. He says, "And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also you are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by Him." And so let's pray together. Father, thank you for the scriptures. Thank you for how that you just make those come alive for us in our lives. And Lord, I just pray tonight that you would just be at work in our lives. Lord, that we would leave here tonight with a heart filled with praise because you have gone above and beyond to work in our lives. So, Lord, we just put this in your hands tonight and ask for your blessings to be upon it. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Amen. When we think about this, praise ought to be the natural outflow of our thanksgiving for what God has done in our life. It ought to just be that natural outflow of what God is doing in our lives. And so, what are some steps that can lead us to have a life of praise? And I want us just to look at this tonight for just a few minutes and just glean some things that I believe that God wants us to see in this. I think that as we begin, I think that praise begins when God rules our heart. Praise begins when God rules our heart. And so when we look at verse 15 and we see that it says, talks about that He gives us peace. Paul says, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts. And so God has to rule in our heart in order that we have that peace that He wants us to have. And so we can talk about the fact that we can have peace with God. That we can have peace with God. In John 14:27, Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." And so we can have peace with God in the fact that God is our salvation. God gives us salvation. So we can be at peace with God in our lives. We can know Him in that way so that we can live every day, that we're not having to struggle between, for me, my conviction was only a very short amount of time from the time God convicted me early in the afternoon until that night at church that I was saved. But Kathy's testimony is a little different. She was under conviction for a long time, for months. She was under conviction, and she was afraid for them to go anywhere. She was afraid for her family to do anything because she was afraid that something was going to happen to her. She had that foreboding, that conviction that God puts in our lives to remind us that He is God and that He is drawing us unto Himself. And so we can have that peace with God. But then Paul tells us in Philippians 4:6-7, he says that we can have the peace of God in our lives, that peace can rest upon us. Notice what he says. He says, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God." And listen to this. "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." And so we can see that in this idea of praise, that He gives us peace, and because He gives us peace, we ought to praise Him. We ought to praise Him. But then we can see also that not only does He give us peace, but He gives us a passion. Notice what He says in the second part of verse 15. He says, "To which also ye are called in one body." You see, He has called us, and next Sunday night, when we get together for that seven sayings service, that there are going to be six or seven churches represented at that. And what is the common bond? Now, we may do things a little different when we come together for our individual worship services and everything. There may be some little differences in that. But the one thing that is bringing us together is that we are called together in one body.
Yeah.